Abandon Jesus, and ye shall receive power. This is your daily devotional reading.
Inspired by the Spirit, August 7th, The Historian Using Secular Sources. For as much as many have taken in hand to set forth in order a declaration of those things which are most surely believed among us, even as they delivered them unto us, which from the beginning were eyewitnesses and ministers of the word, it seemed good to me also, having had perfect understanding of all things from the very first, to write unto thee in order, most excellent Theophilus. Luke 1 verses 1 through 3. As the Spirit of God hath opened to my mind the great truth of his word, and the sins of the past and the future, I have been bidden to make known to others that which hath thus been revealed, to trace the history of the controversy in past ages, and especially so to present it as to shed a light on the fast approaching struggle of the future. In pursuance of this purpose, I have endeavored to select and group together events in the history of the Church in such a manner as to trace the unfolding of the great testing truth that at different periods have been given to the world, that have excited the wrath of Satan and the enmity of a world-loving church, and that have been maintained by the witness of those who love not their lives even unto the death. Revelation 12 verse 11. The great events which have marked the progress of reform in past ages are matters of history well known and universally acknowledged by the Protestant world. They are facts which none can gainsay. This history I have presented briefly in accordance with the scope of the book and the brevity which must necessarily be observed. The facts have been condensed into as little space as seemed consistent with a proper understanding of their application. In some cases where a historian has so grouped together events as to afford, in brief, a comprehensive view of the subject, or has summarized details in a convenient manner, his words have been quoted, but in some instances no specific credit has been given, since the quotations are not given for the purpose of citing that writer as authority, but because his statement affords a ready and forcible presentation of the subject. In narrating the experience and views of those carrying forward the work of reform in our time, similar use has been made of their published works. Inspired by the Spirit, August 7th.